Good morning, everyone, and thank you, Mr. Mr. of the Royal Thai Embassy, Beijing, Mr. Benjamin, and Dr. Pasupa, the Minister Council of the Embassy, to invite me having this opportunity at this meeting to give this speech, share some thoughts and what we have done and achieved in Thailand. I did a little mistake by the PA, my presentation, which is all in English. So, to be fair with both Thai and Chinese colleagues, so I will give the presentation in Chinese instead. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, my dear colleague, for participating in this event and taking the opportunity of today. I would like to introduce you more about the related works done by Chinese Innovation, CAS Innovation Cooperation Center, Bangkok. And first of all, I would like to thank our Thai partners and also Guangxi Department of Science and Technology for the great support. We have entered into a close tie with Guangxi, and in the next step, we're going to have in-depth cooperation in Guangxi and also in Thailand. So I can basically control the slides myself. So the collaboration with Guangxi Autonomous Region not only limited to Bangkok, Thailand, but also on a broader sense for international technology transfer and incubation, covering different countries. You can see different continents, like for example, Africa, ASEAN countries, and the APAC regions, and Latin Americans. So this is our wide scope for technology transfer and related commercialization or industrialization. Actually, we want to become a platform with the international vision that can and also can radicate or can generate influence among the ASEAN countries. So we want to build a channel between the between China and ASEAN countries for mutual communication and exchange, and also we want to build a technology transfer and commercialization center to serve not only the regional market but also the global market. And lastly, we want to become a contributor to provide talent and young scientists the exchange and training. Actually, we have been a visit to the princess and also related the royal families of Thailand. So that is a great support for us to further improve our activities in China and Thailand for science and technology collaboration. And dating back to 2000, in 2019, when Premier Li Keqiang visited Thailand, we have the Prime Minister of Thailand and Premier Li Keqiang sharing us the suggestions and also witnessed the signing of the agreement. And in 2020, based on the previous collaboration between us, we further enhanced the collaboration and further enhanced our effort to work together. Just as mentioned by Mr. Cao, we have a working panel, a working group to promote to actually promote the local collaboration. Currently speaking, we have higher education institutions, government bodies to join us on board. Just for example, we work together with Narrate Thailand closely, and the upcoming project R3. So we are working with the Thailand optics to build related devices and physical hardwares. And also with the we have set up an incubator which is based in a university campus that is also highly supported by the Chinese parties. We also work together with a university in Thailand to set up the China Thailand joint collaboration or joint laboratory for herbal medicine or traditional medicine. And we also centering on the Thailand 4.0 and Thailand BCG strategy to cover our cooperation covers almost every aspect. So next, I would like to introduce you about the technology transfer and science and technology leadership. So our experience in these two aspects. So first of all, we have a close collaboration and understanding with the local Thai markets, and have very great friendship with the local with Thai company. One of them is SCG, very influential on the Thai market. So we have built a complete and sound collaboration with that company, and we have the physical space. We have four international standard and a laboratory. So that serves the foundation for the green technologies from China to Thailand. So this is the technology transfer and commercialization facilities of green economy. And also during the pandemic period or during the preparation period, we have received great funding support from Thailand. And as unfortunately, the pandemic also hit Thailand, we connected with different parties. For example, some companies from private sectors in Shanghai municipality, we have successfully introduced the large scale imaging facilities to Thai hospitals. Regional hospitals in Thailand. And this is a kind of like high technology, high quality devices or products to, this is the first case ever of such a large scale and high precision medical equipment to be landed or to be implemented in a ASEAN country. So this is the first time ever in the history, and that can be also a breakthrough. As also mentioned by the other speakers, we work together with Guangxi authorities and other authorities together to jointly combat COVID. For example, we have issued the first ever paper literature about the protein structure of the COVID virus. And also, we have screened or filtered different natural ingredients or herbals bioactivity materials and to contribute to the COVID pandemic fighting or campaign, trying to develop some solution or formula from the medical perspective to support our effort in COVID. And also, this is this slide shows you about the collaboration of China ASEAN Technology Transfer and Innovation Conference. And we have set up a platform which has been inaugurated on that Science and Technology Innovation Conference. I think next month we can basically finish the decoration of the incubator heart working place at the space. So that would serve as a platform for a mutual understanding or a mutual exchange between China and Thailand. So we can introduce the Chinese experts or young talents to Thailand, and also send the Thai experts or young talents to China. And also with the government support and royal family support from Thailand, the technology transfer works really smoothly on the international scope. And also for green technology, we have received great funding support and capital support. For example, we have the Green Technology Bank system, which has been initiated in the in 2015. We are preparing for a branch or a local office in Guangxi Autonomous Region to facing or to target on the ASEAN countries. So that office has been supported greatly by the Guangxi local government and also the ministries or science and technology authorities from APAC, and also from UNESCO and ISO and Other international organizations shows great support as well. We have successfully attracted the ASEAN Development ASEAN Development Bank and other green venture capital institutions or green capital green funding organizations. And finally, I just want to share some of my personal experience or insights. So I think in technology transfer and commercialization, or in the spreading of science and technology power, talents are very necessary. Besides the incubator, we in Thailand, we also set up our office in Singapore and other a part of ASEAN countries. So this is the ultimate goal is to help to have the talent training and cultivation for technology transfer. And for example, as mentioned by the previous speaker, Mr. Cao from China ASEAN Technology Transfer Center, we have set up training sessions to educate those technology transfer managers and management personnel. And also we have some of the platform to land in China. So we have created an equivalent a counterpart in China to have further or more in-depth collaboration. So connecting the two dots, China and foreign countries. And also we work with the Singapore universities for more talent cultivation. Now, this is about the Thailand. We are actually working with the Thai partners to initiate different programs in the four in areas of Thailand in terms of poverty alleviation, incubation, operation, and all types of fields and aspects. We're working closely with Thai partners, and we want to have this kind of a long-term standard and sustainable collaboration between us. And in the future, we can replicate this model to other ASEAN countries. So Thai is a very great example for us, currently speaking, for the China-ASEAN Science and Technology Innovation Alliance. Or so I think this kind of example or experience can be copied to the other ASEAN countries. So, and also in the preliminary work part of my work, we also analyzed the roadmap. This is a summary of the roadmap for local innovation, entrepreneurship, and technology cooperation. So this, as an asset, has been shared with related parties. I believe it has become a very standard mechanism or effective mechanism for China and Thai to develop science and technology cooperation. Taking this advantage, I would like to introduce to you, and I hope we can have more like collaboration opportunities, for example, on single projects or et cetera. So finally, I gave you a brief summary of all the work we have done with the support of the Guangxi Zhuang Autonomous Region and the local Department of Science and Technology and our Thai partners. We have built a very sound and healthy business model that serves the technology transfer and commercialization in science and technology, and especially for market-oriented practices and activities, we have built an ecosystem. So we have our stakeholders, companies, and research centers, university, higher educations, incubators, and investors, and the technology transfer, IP, and patent, and government support, talent cultivation, all those elements are involved in this ecosystem. So personally speaking, I think you can see on the slides, I just gave you a very brief summary from the perspective of innovation. We have highlighted several campaigns or efforts. The first one is initiation. We want originality. We want some original piece or breakthrough or first ever. So that means initiation is very critical. And the second is intelligence. So innovation is built on intelligence. intelligence not only in the technology perspective, but also in talent perspective. So we need intelligence and information collection, processing, summary, analysis, or to fully tap the potential of information and data to drive our technology transfer and related activities. Interest is very important as well, because for the team, we are highly interested in the ASEAN market, Thai market, and APAC market. So that is what we have done, to always have the passion and interest.
And next is inclusive, because inevitably there will be setbacks, there will be challenges. So an inclusive mind is one of the important aspects of our collaborations. Another thing is integration. To integrate, because all the technology transfer depends on exchange and integration. So I hope that while I'm introducing CAS ICCB and some of our works in overseas markets, especially in Thailand, can be fruitful, and you guys can have some takeaway from my presentation, hopefully. Thank you.